8th class biology, production of food from plants, agricultural practices. We are mainly dependent on agriculture for our food. Most of our food products are obtained from plants. The plants which are grown in large number to get useful food products are known as crops. The process of growing crops is called agriculture. How many days are required for getting the crops? Is growth period for all the crops same? The growth period for all the crops is not same. Some crops like jowar and red gram takes a minimum of 180 days or more for harvesting. Such crops are called long-term crops. Some crops like green gram, black gram takes 100 days for harvesting, and such crops are called short-term crops. Pulses, this is also one type of short-term crop. The crops that grow in rainy season, June to October, are termed as kharif or rainy season crops. Example, paddy. The crops that are grown only in winter season, that is October to January or April, are generally called rabi or summer season crops. Wheat, maize, coriander, fenugreek, barley, etc. are rabi crops. These are the various steps in agriculture. It starts from preparation of the soil and up to the storage of the crop yield. Let us know about the agricultural practices in detail. Farmers divide the field into plots, then each plot is plowed and harrowed. Before growing crops, proper plowing of the soil is necessary. Plowing loosens the soil and it helps in easy transportation of air and water. Water is sorted deeply for a long time as the soil is soft. Roots penetrate in the deep and can respire well as the air enters easily into the soil. Soil-friendly microorganisms and earthworms can grow well when the soil is soft. Some faux microorganisms, insect eggs, come out and die due to the sun rays. Wooden plow used for plowing. See here, they are plowing in the wet fields. Plowing with a tractor attached with agricultural tool called puttler. After plowing and preparing the soil in the wet fields, the farmers, they are leveling the fields. Leveling the fields with various agricultural tools. A puttler attached to a tractor. This is a iron plow to be attached with a tractor. Leveling tool, plowing agricultural tool, wooden plow, and a leveling tool, big plow set. What are the important activities in the cultivation of paddy or rice? In the cultivation of paddy, it involves a series of activities. In those activities, selection and sowing of seeds are very important. Before sowing, farmers select good quality seeds. The healthy seeds gives healthy crop. Testing the seed quality. See how the seeds are appearing? For a healthy crop, we require quality seeds. The best seeds will be full and uniform in size. They should be with the same color and no cracks or spotting. Seeds should be free from weed seed or other rice varieties mixed in by accident. Seeds should be free from disease and germination capacity should be 80% and above. Seed germination test. To do a germination test, first take a plate or tray, then put 100 seeds half a centimeter deep into the soil in rows. Cover the seeds with soil. Add a little water so that the soil is moist. Keep this tray in a separate place. After 5 to 6 days, count the number of seedlings with healthy roots and shoots. Count the number of seedlings is the germination percentage. Selecting seeds using the flotation technique. For each kilogram of seed, 1 liter of water is needed. Pour the seeds into the water. Good quality seeds will sink and poor quality seeds will float. Remove the poor quality seeds. Wash good quality seeds with clean water 3-4 times. Washing in clean water is important. Seed treatment. Treat each kilogram of seed you will sow with the 3 grams of carbendazim fungicide in 1 liter of clean water. Soak seeds in water mixed with fungicide for 12 hours. After 12 hours, remove the water and wash the seeds with clean water. Put treated seeds in a wet jute bag and place them in the shade. Keep them aside. Keep the jute bag wet by sprinkling of water regularly. Seeds usually sprouts in 2-3 days. Does all the farmers follow same method in germinating the seeds? Another method in seed germination. Farmers soak the certified seeds directly. Certified seeds are usually very high quality and good germination percentage also. Distributing pre-germinated seeds in the well-prepared seed beds. After sowing, keep the walkway between the beds full of water. 4-5 days after seeds germinate and maintain 2-3 cm water on top of the beds for 5-6 days. Do not let the soil develop cracks. If needed, splash the water from the walking area and drain on the beds. Does all the farmers follow the same procedure to prepare seed bed? Collect the series or different activities done by the farmers in the Kharif and Rabi season. Analyze and make a brief report on it. Preparing the soil. Preparing the seed bed. Leave sufficient space between seed beds and ensure the seed beds are free from water storage. Direct seeding method. How the direct seeding method is there? See here. Distributing the treated quality seeds in the seed bed directly. The seeds germinate in few days and produce quality seedlings. Seed bed requires sufficient water and nutrients. After the suitable growth, the seedlings are uprooted, transported and transplanted in the soil. When the seedlings show 4-5 leaves, they can readily be transplanted. Uprooting the seedlings from the nursery plot. Before uprooting, flood seed beds so the soil is underwater to avoid damaging shoots and roots when you uproot seedlings. When the plants grow to certain height, farmers pick out the seedlings from the plots and make bundles. Uproot seedlings by holding several between thumb and forefinger at the base of the seedling and pulling gently sideways. How they are removing the seedlings from the nursery plot? So they are carefully handling the seedlings and they are bundling the seedlings. After uprooting the seedlings, these seedlings are transported to the transplanted area. Transplant the seedlings as early as possible after uprooting. When carrying seedlings to the field, be extra careful and not to crush or dry out the seedlings. It is best to carry seedlings in a basket. Transportation of seedlings. After transportation of seedlings to the transplanted area, farmers starts the transplantation process. Remember, healthy seedlings are a must for better yield. Paddy plants are sown in proper distances. This is called transplanting, not veyadam. Why the seedlings are replanted at proper distances? If they are very near to each other, they will compete for water, nutrients and sunlight. The paddy variety Sri Vari requires much gap between the plants. Sri means here system of rice intensification. Transplantation method and crop yield are closely related. Ask your elders How many plantlets are planted at one place? Is it one or 5 to 6 plants as a group? Do farmers follow this transplantation method for all type of crops? Do you know what a paddy planter is? This is a paddy planter. It is used in the paddy transplantation. It is useful for farmers, those who cultivate paddy in large areas. It is easy to maintain proper distance in sowing the seedlings. It is time-saving and money-saving process. Different types of paddy planter machines are available in the market. How do farmers get high yield? Plants require nutrients to grow, which are obtained from soil. Manure is needed for healthy growth of the plants. Manure contains nitrogen, phosphorus, potash, it means NPK, etc. Manure is of two types. Natural manure, it means biofertilizers. Artificial manure, that is chemical fertilizers. Natural manure is also called biofertilizers. In rural areas, farmers dump plant and animal wastes outside the village in an open space. See here the dump of plant and animal wastes. Some bacteria like Azotobacter and Nitrobacter decompose it into manure which contain nutrients. Biofertilizers are formed by decomposing plant and animal wastes. This manure, when added to the soil, it provides nutrients to the plants. Natural fertilizer increase the soil health. Artificial fertilizer. These are prepared in factories. These are also called chemical fertilizers. Have you ever observed chemical fertilizers? Rice plants need nutrients to be healthy to produce a profitable yield. The most important nutrients needed by rice is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, zinc, sulfur, etc. Different types of complex manure available in the market. See here 1620, 4600, 1620. It indicates 16% of nitrogen, 20% of phosphorus, 0% of potassium. 14-14-14 means 14% of nitrogen, 14% of phosphorus, 14% of potassium. It means this is a complete fertilizer. See here how the fertilizer is distributed in the rice fields. Let us compare chemical natural fertilizers and which manure is beneficial. Chemical fertilizers, these are made up of inorganic salts. While natural fertilizers, these are made by the decomposition of plant and animal, it means organic wastes. Chemical fertilizers are prepared in factories. Natural fertilizers are prepared in open places. By the chemical fertilizers, humus is not deposited in soil. By the natural fertilizers, deposit of humus layer is found in the soil. More amount of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium deposits in the soil by the application of chemical fertilizers. Less amount of nitrogen, potassium and phosphorus deposit in the soil by the application of natural fertilizers. Chemical fertilizers decrease the health of the soil, but natural fertilizers increase the soil health. The process of watering crop plants in the field is known as irrigation. The source of water should be at a higher level so that each and every part of the field gets water. Ponds, wells and canals are common sources of water. Farmers irrigate their fields either manually using bullocks or by using pumps. Two methods of irrigation which are commonly practiced in our country. In furrow irrigation method, the water is allowed to enter the field through channels or furrows made between two rows of crop. See here basin irrigation. In this method of irrigation, the field is just filled with water as in the case of paddy. Sometimes field get excess water which the soil is unable to absorb. This condition is called water lagging. Water lagging is harmful to most crops as it does not allow the roots to breathe. Therefore, provision should be made for draining the excess amount of water from the fields. Why water is essential for plants? The nutrients in the soil should be transported to the plants properly. For this, it should be dissolved in water. The ancient irrigation techniques. This is called as chain pump or Bukkenla Bavi. One more, the ancient irrigation technique, Yatam. One more, the ancient irrigation technique, this is Gudaveyatam. Modern methods of irrigation, sprinkler. It is used for conserving water in agriculture in the areas where water is scarcely available. It provides uniform watering all over the field. It works on the principle of force of water. Modern method of irrigation observed is drip irrigation. As the water reaches the plants drop by drop, this is called drip irrigation. Visit a nearby crop field and observe sprinkler and drip system. Prepare your own report. This should contain apparatus, water resource, investment and maintenance, merits and demerits. Nowadays, pumps are commonly used for lifting water. What are the ways that the farmers of your place supply water to the fields? If you observe a crop field, you will find that some other plants growing there side by side. These are undesirable plants called weeds. They should be removed immediately. Why should we remove weeds? The weeds compete with the primary crops for nutrients, water, and light. Because of weed plants, the prime plants may not grow properly, hence they should be removed. Ichshayimam, Fimbristylis, Echinoclova, Ageratum, Cypress, Echinoclova glabrescens are example for the weed plants. Weeding is done by different methods by the farmers. Uprooting manually. Generally, farmers uproot the weed plants manually by hand picking. Crushing with legs. The weed plants are crushed directly into the soil. Using a cono weeder. This also crushes the weed plants into the soil directly. Using power weeder. So many types of power weeders are available in the market. Farmers use weedicides like 2,4-D to control the dicotyledons weeds. Do you agree that plants also fall ill like us? The growing crop is attractive food for the moth, caterpillars, paddy beetles and their larvae, paddy grasshoppers, fungi, virus, bacteria and aphids. In plants, some diseases are caused due to the deficiency of the nutrients. Aphids attack on crops. Some insects like aphids and the whitefly, besides sucking plant sap, also carry viral infections. The honeydew is released from aphids, also attracts the insects and harm the crop plants. Fungal disease. Black spot fungal disease. Inside the picture, see the disease symptoms of Ticca disease of groundnuts. Nitrogen is important for the growth and repair or maintenance in the plants. Chlorosis. As we know, magnesium is the key element in the chlorophyll. Deficiency of the magnesium leads to the chlorosis. Rice crop is attacked by so many diseases and disease-causing agents, green insects and some other diseases. By the summer plowing, some faux microorganisms, insect eggs come out and die due to the sun rays. What will we do to croplands which are affected by the diseases? Farmers use pesticides in the pest controlling practices by spraying. Duster is used to distribute dry powdery material. Some pesticides and fertilizers are distributed directly by the hands. Spraying, dusting using biopesticides, burning, picking are also used in the pest controlling practices. Some bio remedies also used in the pest controlling practices. Some pesticides act on particular species of pests, but many pesticides are harmful to other harmless and useful insects. Using pesticides is very harmful to our environment. A wide variety of agricultural and garden pesticides are available. A few derived from plants like neem, tobacco, and chrysanthemum are less dangerous to other living things. Harvesting is the most important task in agriculture. Collecting grains from the crop by cutting the mature plant is called harvesting. Paddy crop harvesting can be done by hand using a sickle. Threshing. The dry plant's stalks are beaten on a hard surface to remove the grain. Threshing is also done with the help of bullocks, which trample the grain. Nowadays, machines are also using for the purpose of threshing. Modern harvesting machine, harvester. Nowadays, it is a common practice to harvest the crop with the help of a harvester. For the crop harvesting purpose, there are many agricultural tools and machines present in the market. After the collection of seeds, farmers separate the grain and chaff by the method called winnowing. For this, they use a manual winnower by using chata and fan or winnowing machine. If the paddy is not dried well enough, what will happen? If moisture is there in the grains, it helps to develop molds or fungi. Such grains neither germinates nor suitable to eat. Drying, generally sun drying. Why we prefer sun drying instead of other methods? This is very cheap and environmentally friendly. Options for sun drying. One is field drying. Second one is panicle drying. Only panicles are collected from the crop fields and later they are dried separately. Drying on nets, mats or canvas. This is the common practice in the rural areas. Drying on pavement or in special areas. There are different storage practices in our state. Naturally, food produce can be damaged by fungi, pests, rats and bacteria. To overcome this problem, farmers dry the grains for 2 to 3 days in sun. After drying, they keep the grain in a jute bags and preserve them in a godown. Have you ever seen farmers harvesting the crops on roads? In some villages, farmers harvest their crops on the roads instead of using bullocks. It is a dangerous practice. Sometimes accidents may occur. After the drying process is completed, the grain is filled in the gunny or jute bags and preserved in the godowns or warehouses. It is a cold storage unit. Here the vegetables, fruits, tamarind, chilies and other products are stored. As the temperature is very low here, the vegetables and fruits can be kept for a longer time in the cold storage unit. E-content prepared by Professor Prabhakar Reddy. Attributions. Attributions and thanks. Attributions thanks to attributions.